Greetings, Commanders. Welcome to the Pocket Hoodoo video. Every once in a while, the meta of the game shifts to a way where you can find a new way to exploit Commanders. And if you've been following this channel and you're a member of this community, then you've probably seen what Hoodoo can do. And I want to talk about why I think every Commander needs Hoodoo. You have to have him in your Commander arsenal. I've talked about Weenie Commanders and Plasma and Rogers and how they all have a utility. I haven't done like a full-blown explanation of how you can use Rogers, but I will get to that one day. Right now we're talking Hoodoo. And yeah, there's a lot of great commanders out there. You can get a Golem, but Golem's skills directly scale with his items, his leadership, and his level, right? His crush level. The more troops, the harder he hits, right? Well, the thing about Hoodoo is his ability, Death Rattle, doesn't matter if you have 100,000 leadership or 1,000 leadership, because if you kill a stack of troops, it does damage to all of the opponent's troops. Unlike Plasma, who he has to die, and preferably in one shot, so his troop slot does more damage because he had more troops when he died to the other team. Unlike Plasma, Hoodoo just hits the opponent's troops and blows everything up. Now, early on in the game, this is not a very useful thing. Everyone sends full marches, full tier 7, full rows, front rows, whatever. And that's when Plasma became like useful, because you could use tier 2 and tier suppression hadn't become a thing yet. So you could get away with using tier 2 against someone's high tier. And then they figure out tier suppression, and now your Plasma needs to use high tier troops. Well, if you didn't have infantry research, Plasma wasn't very good. And tier suppression kind of killed him. But Hoodoo is kind of opposite. See, if you run Hoodoo like I do, with just a few thousand leadership and high skills, and high tier troops are the highest tier available to you, all you're trying to do is kill the enemy's rangers or low tier troops. And in order to do that, you need to get to them either in the front row or behind the front row. And the only way to get behind the front row, if they send a high tier march in the front, is to use a Libra gem. Libra will do a riposte strike if it triggers. And it's only 20%, but it does trigger. And because of how powerful it is, you can get really legendary stuff in really a low-risk environment. Now, the reason I think Hoodoo is so important for everyone to have in their arsenal is because we've all been there where your ally's shield drops, and you're just like, well, I can't get a hold of them. They're not online. I've messaged them in-game. They're not getting the notifications on their phone. They're just out there, and they're about to get hit, or you know that the person that always fights your guild the most is gunning for them, looking for them. Maybe they have a bounty on them. And you have no way of helping, because you can't beat your enemy's biggest march, and you know they're going to send it. So what do? You say, all right, well, everyone send a black hole. At least that way you can punish them a little bit for hurting your ally. And it makes them say, okay, well, the last time I hit this person, their guild had 3 black holes on them. So instead of sending all tier 10, maybe they'll send, or all tier 7, they'll send just one slot of tier 7 to make sure they win the fight. But in the other rows, they'll just send tier 1 so that the black hole doesn't do damage to all tier 7. It just does black hole damage to one slot, and the rest are just rangers or tier 1. And once you can get your enemies to start sending lower risk marches, where they still want to pillage and massacre as much as possible, but they don't send the expensive troops, then you can catch them with Hoodoo. And if anyone remembers, there's the... Gan had a legendary replay. It's here we go. The $1 million death rattle, and this is on Devil Style's channel. And what we have here is a really high-level replay, and I don't want people to get lost and say, well, this only works on high-tier troops, and I'm not at that point in the game. Listen, you can get away with this at tier 5, tier 6, tier 7, no problem. The same rules apply. Now, granted, at higher tiers, Hoodoo can use airships like I use, but in this replay, you'll see what happens. So this Golem obviously can't afford to send tier 10 in all of his slots because he has so much leadership. Those ships cost so much, they just can't afford to do it. Even the number one player in the game has 850,000 leadership. He doesn't even have 2 slots at tier 11. So they end up sending other tier in the other slots, and that's what you want to do. You want to catch them with that low tier because they're way more vulnerable to higher tier damage. So tier suppression with the Libra gem helps, and then the skill on Libra also helps. But in this replay, you'll see that the Awakening hit, crushed all the troops in the front, And these walkers aren't going to do anything to these other tier 10 airships. They're just not going to do enough. He's trying to get to that back row. And here we are. We're still going. The awakenings are going off. The chain blast is only hitting the front row. The awakening for walkers only hits the front row. Chain blast only hits the front row. So getting to hit the back row for Hoodoo is really hard. So a Libra is the only thing that can do it. Or Gemini if you break through and hit it on your first turn. But we'll talk about Gemini here in a second. Now, you'll notice his tier suppression is not letting the tier 2 do any damage. But he also gets a huge benefit, a damage bonus over that lower tier. So even though he's only got 50 units, he's going to be able to kill, you know, what is that, friggin' 80,000 leadership worth. So he triggers the Libra, doesn't do much damage to that front row, does a decent amount, gets a nice chain blast off, but then the back row triggers. Now, he has a Libra set going, does zero damage, but he gets a riposte, boom, kills 9,000, and all that damage spreads to the other troops. Legendary hit. And you can do that on your server with just a tiny little Hoodoo. Now, granted, Gan's Hoodoo is massive. He's got great gear and high-tier troops. But you don't have to do that. If you saw my replay last week, I did something where I just crushed through Rangers because enemies on our server know that if you want to do... if you want to send big marches, just be prepared to get hit by plasma bombs and black holes, so they only like to send one troop at a time. But even DCL on our server knows... that, you know, we have Hoodoos. So he's got to protect his front row. Let's see. Oh, this is Gan's replay. What am I doing? Wrong one, guy. But even he knows that, you know, you got to send something to protect your front row and back row. But occasionally they make mistakes. They make mistakes, and that's when you catch them big. So when you're in a situation where you want to catch your opponent and punish them, you also kind of have to condition them to stop sending full marches so that you can catch them with these smaller marches Hoodoos with you know, shots in the back. But there's one more thing I want to cover, so I hope I don't get lost in all this video movement here, is that once you can condition them to start sending smaller marches, you can get them to start sending Rangers eventually. And part of the thing that we're not really talking about here is that you need to march fast. Like, when stuff goes down, as the game moves on, it gets faster and faster and faster. As months go by, players will attack, 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 shield right away, or attack, shield right away, and burn through 20 or 30 shields when stuff gets crazy, just to protect their own their halls, because people will spend a few thousand gold speed marching to them. Well, when you're doing that kind of stuff, you preset your troop loadout, and then you just click on the slot you want to change, and then you change it to whatever troop you want or the amount you want, which takes more time. The more clicks you have to do, the more time it takes. Well, in this march, I had garrisoned an ally. DCL had seen the garrison on a previous march. And instead of putting all the troops in slot one, he knew my Hoodoo would blow that slot up. But he didn't remember to change the third slot. Or maybe he did and he accidentally misclicked. But he sent a full march in that third slot. And what ends up happening is my awakening goes off. Or my chain blast goes off, one or the other. I think it's awakening. Boom. And it blows everything up. Huge mistake on his part. But let's say I didn't get the awakening and I still wanted to do damage. Yes, the Libra helps because I'll always use Libra on Hoodoo for this kind of build. But Gemini would technically be better. Now, I run Taurus because it has bonus damage and I want to make sure I one-shot the slot. Because if you do all the damage in one shot, it does more damage. If you knock half the slot down, then kill the slot, like Gemini would sometimes do, then you don't hit for as much. It doesn't hit as hard. But in this case, I could have skipped that first slot and killed the back row, which would have done that same explosion damage. So going back to gear, let's talk about that. So the absolute best gems in the game for this type of pocket Hoodoo build is, you know, you'd think you'd want a lot of accuracy and stuff, but realistically... not if you're doing this specific style. And the reason is because you're going to be hitting Rangers. Rangers are never going to dodge higher tier Walker. If you're tier 3 or higher against tier 1 Rangers on your opponent's side, no matter what they do, they will never dodge your tier 3 or higher. So accuracy is not that important for this type of pocket Hoodoo build. If you're maining Hoodoo, that's a whole different build. You're going to want to use, you know, Scorpio, Taurus, Leo Gem, stuff like that. But for this type of build, you want to go four-piece Libra, four-piece Gemini. And as far as weapons are concerned, if you have tier 9, great. You can use airships or you can use walkers. Walkers hit harder, and you probably are going against rangers more often than not. So if you can use walker, go for it. But if your research is into air, use air. But if you haven't got to tier 9, you're still under the lower tier stuff, and you want to take advantage of this, which I recommend everyone do. You don't need to get level 46 in the skill. You can get level 30. But okay, back to damage. You can use the Apocalyptor if you have it. It's a great damage item. Definitely the best for walker specific. If not, you can substitute that for, oh gosh, do I have it? Yep. Dragon Slayer has a raw 32% attack, or was it 30? Oh, I should double check that. Maybe it's 20, 30, 20. But that's what you'd build, double Dragon Slayer until you get better damage items. Critting is important. Crit damage is important. So Skywalkers would also be a viable option. So let's see. How close is that damage? 13 on that. Yeah, I think Skywalkers are not always going to be a better solution. Yeah, they will. We'll say, okay, Apocalyptor first. If you don't have Apocalyptor, Skywalkers are fine. If you don't have Skywalkers, for this build alone, you can get away with Dragon Slayers, okay? As far as the helmet's concerned, dodging is really nice in this type of build. If you have a similar tier against your opponent, you might be able to get lucky and dodge a few times to get that Libra to trigger and kill the back row. But I don't know if I would sacrifice damage for it, depending on how much leadership you have and how much troops you're using. You just kind of have to estimate. If you know your opponent's always hitting on 20 or 30,000 leadership or whatever it is, make sure you have enough troops and damage to one slot, the stack of Rangers or Tier 1 airships, whatever you can condition them to start sending. So, you know, kind of use your best judgment on if you can get away with Magiwell Pants for extra damage or if you have to use Dodge to survive a little longer to roll those dice a few more times, because you're not going to get it every time. You're not going to get lucky every time, but you're only risking a small amount compared to what they're sending. But eventually you'll land something, and it's going to be legendary, and I want to know about it. So maybe that's the thing. Get your guild together. Show them this video. Talk to them about getting value out of commanders that you don't need to pour a lot of resources or leadership into. Just get their skills high, get them some basic gear, and just start garrisoning allies, garrisoning the fort, and try to bait people in. And if they constantly send big marches and you just can't get your hooded to land any good marches or good hits, start black holing them. I know that black holes cost cash. I know they cost shadow matter. I know that you're trying to save up to build your next research, but it only takes 3 or 4 people in one day to black hole somebody really hard, so they stop sending full marches of troops and they just send slots 1 through 3 or slots 1 with a bunch of low tier and the rest. And once you get them thinking like, ah, just send my Rangers and chain slot 1, I'll win the fight and I'll only get black holed in one slot, then that's when you catch them. You don't need Hoodoo at S-Class. The extra awakening does help. But to be fair, you know, his first skill, Chain Blast, does hit pretty hard. Not as good as Awakening. Awakening triggers more often. It does hit slightly harder, 50% harder. So essentially, you do want to get Hoodoo to S, and one day you will. So don't worry about it. Level these skills up to 30-30. That should be pretty functional, and you can add it to your commander repertoire. You should have a bullet. You should have a rock or a bullet, not necessarily both, but one or the other for ignore tier suppression skills. You should have a Hoodoo. You probably already have a plasma, but I think right now Hoodoo serves more function and has much higher potential to do catastrophic damage to your opponents than plasma does. And Hoodoo does it because he can kill those high leadership small troop marches. And as people just start pumping their leadership up, you'll catch them because they won't have enough troops to fill all those slots. They'll have lower tier stuff, and you can get them. So use the highest tier you can. Use the highest damage you can. Use Gemini Libra to break through the front row. Start saving those replays, guys. Let's see what you can do. Show me your best Hoodoo replays. Pocket Hoodoo week coming up. Let's see what you guys can do. If you're seeing this a month in advance or a month from now, and you do have a legendary replay, put it on YouTube or hit me up online. It's melt.aow. If you're not in our community, just let me know you want to join, and I will throw you the nice invite, and I look forward to seeing your guys' replays and seeing what you guys can do with it. But this could be a game changer. Maybe not so much in Galactic Battle, but definitely on your servers and PvP. You can really start scaring your big players if they are afraid of black holes and afraid of Hoodoo bombs, because you just can't easily counter a march like this without sending a bunch of low tier. And if you condition them to always send only low tier, you can just beat them with tier suppression marches. So Anyway, back to the gear if I miss it. You definitely want to use Black Knight eventually for that extra tier suppression. Damage on the head, damage on the pants, damage on the weapons. Or dodge if you don't have good damage there yet and you want to survive a bit longer to trigger those Libras. And don't kid yourself. You will have some bad luck. You will totally lose everything sometimes. But eventually you will get a huge hit off and really set your top players back a few weeks, if not months. So anyway, I hope you like this video. I hope you guys actually utilize it and find a way to make him, you know, a facet in your commander lineup and on your server. And yeah, thanks for watching this video. We'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye.